This video examines how to do distribution fitting using the SPC for Excel software. Suppose we have a set of data that we'd like to model using a certain distribution. We'd like to find out what distribution fits the data the best. So we enter our data into an Excel spreadsheet as we've done here. We have 100 data points in column A. So after we've entered the data, we simply select distribution fitting from the SPC for Excel ribbon. If there's a word in that first cell, it assumes it's the variable name, then the data range is underneath it. Then you have the option to run one or more of the 14 distributions that can be fit. We have the exponential, we have gamma, we have the largest extreme value, logistic, loglogistic, lognormal, normal, smallest extreme value, and of course the Weibull. So we can select just one or two or three of them to run, or we can run all of them. And let's run all of them in this example. So we do that, select OK. And what happens is the program gives you the progress of fitting it as it goes through each of the 14 distributions. Then after fitting it, it begins to plot the results. And it gives you the results of those plots on the in the workbook as we go along. And then you finish on our summary page, which gives the results. Let's take a closer look at the summary page before we take a look at some of the individual distribution pages. The summary pages include the descriptive statistics for the raw data, count, mean, standard deviation, etc. And then down below are the results of our distribution fitting. This part of the summary page deals with the distribution fitting themselves. What the software does is it uses MLE, or maximum likelihood estimation, to estimate for each distribution the location, shape, scale, and or threshold. And these are the best fit values that the software found. And the log likelihood is the result of the maximum likelihood estimation technique. And it's going to be used over in this AIC value, which is why we include it. And we'll talk about that in just a moment. The rest of the summary page deals with how well the data fits the distribution. And it involves four columns here. We'll start with the Anderson-Darling statistic. That's the value that's in this column. And next to that is the p-value associated with that Anderson-Darling statistic. The larger the p-value, theoretically, the better the fit. So with p-value here, it's greater than 0.25 for the Weibull distribution, says that's a pretty good fit. That's a good fit. Down here with the smallest extreme value, our p-value is less than 0.01, which says it's not a very good fit. This column contains the likelihood ratio test, and what this does is it measures how well a additional parameter helps the fit. For example, on the log normal, we come across here and we see that we had an Anderson-Darling statistic that has a p-value of 0.001, but when we go from the 2-parameter log normal to the 3-parameter, the p-value increases to 0.179, which would imply that there's a better fit with the 3-parameter. And the likelihood ratio test essentially gives you a value for that. So this is the p-value of 0.007, in this case lower is better, which says that adding the 3rd-parameter log normal really helps things. But what we use to determine which model is best is something called the Akiki information criterion, and that's AIC. And what this is, it's a measure of the relative quality of a model when compared to other models, and it's based on the log likelihood result. In this case, smaller values are better, so the results are sorted by AIC to tell you which model is the best. So in this case, again, the Weibull looks pretty good. Down here, the smallest extreme value is not a good fit at all. Now let's take a look at the individual distributions, or a couple of them anyway. They're listed over here in the first column, of course, and there's a link. So you can want to go see the Weibull, which has supposedly the best fit. You select this, it takes you to the page with the results on it. And again, it has the descriptive statistics appear from the raw data. It gives you the results for the distribution, what the program found for the Weibull function. Then it gives you two charts down here. And this first chart involves the probability distribution functions. The empirical, or the data results, are shown as a histogram. And then the distribution, in this case the Weibull with these parameters, is shown as a continuous line. And this distribution should fit that histogram fairly well if it's a good fit. The other plot is a PP plot. And what this plot is, it's plotting the empirical continuous distribution function down here, that's the results from the data, versus the theoretical continuous distribution function. And if it's a good fit, these points should fall along a straight line, as they do here. So all this looks like it's a very good fit between the data and the Weibull. So this probably is a very good model for the data. Now let's return to the summary page, and you can select any of these you want, but the worst fit was the smallest extreme value. You select that, and you can see here that this continuous distribution function does not, the probability distribution function here does not follow the histogram as well, and that the model and the empirical probability distribution functions do not follow along a straight line. You also see that from the p-value for the AD function being less than 0.01. But this allows you to go look at any of the results that you want to see how good of a fit there was going back and forth, so it's very easy to navigate in the distribution fitting portion of the SPC for Excel software. So this is a quick look at how distribution fitting is done using the SPC for Excel software. Hope you found the video enjoyable and useful. Have a great day.